Hi everyone. I want to take a minute to show you a couple of things. The first is going to be select subject. Then I want to show you up here in Photoshop some of these select drop-down options. Some of the stuff you will have gone over in other videos. However, they're important enough that I'd like to go over them again, and I'm not sure that you actually have seen them in all the videos, so I just want to take a minute to kind of step back and show you these couple of things. First of all, you've been learning how to select items on a page, objects on a page, in a file, through the different selection tools over here. Another way you can do it is up here with this select subject option. And we're going to do that in a second. We're going to build on this zombies page. So let me go ahead and grab the file that I want to grab. We're going to put Jack-Jack on there. To select Jack-Jack, I'm going to go up to Select, Subject, and Photoshop automatically chooses the subject that's on the page. It does not do it perfectly. Back here, it didn't quite get the arm correct. I could come up to my lasso tool at this point, and I'm clicking on the option key, maybe get rid of some of that area that shouldn't be selected with the subject. I'm not really going to worry too much about that now. The idea is I want to get Jack-Jack selected, and then I want to copy and I want to paste him to that other file. We've done a little copy pasting in here, but in Photoshop you're going to be doing a lot of it. So let's just go over that again. I can choose Command C for copy and then Command V for paste. Or if you forget that, you can come up here and go Edit, Copy. Photoshop is going to copy the pixels that are selected on the layer that is chosen. Toggle back to Zombies and go up to Edit, Paste. Let's go ahead and paste it. Just paste it on the page. I'm going to go Edit, Undo. And this time I'm going to go Edit, Paste Special, Paste in Place. What this will do, in this case, it happens to be in the same place it was before. But sometimes, if you start pasting things on a page, and you want them to be in the exact same spot as where they came out of to begin with, you choose Paste in Place to get it into that location. Otherwise, Photoshop might drop it to the left or to the right or in another location. So I'm going to take, with my Move tool, I'm going to take Jack-Jack, and I'm going to bring him over to the right a little bit, I think. And then I want to have Mrs. Incredible running in to save him. So let me find her file. I'm opening up Mrs. Incredible, and I'm going to do the same thing. Select subject. And look how great this selected it. Most of the time, though, you're going to have a file that is not this clean. This background is obviously an illustration or a painting. And Mrs. Incredible is really easy to choose off of that. So again, I'm going to go Command-C for copy, back to zombies, Command-V for paste. Okay, and I'm going to move Mrs. Incredible over here. Now she's facing the wrong direction. She has to be running towards Jack-Jack. So I'm gonna come up here and go Edit, Transform. Oops, let me grab it. This may be out of what you guys are showing, but if you go straight down to the bottom, there's a flip horizontal, and that is Mrs. Incredible. Okay, move her a little bit more towards Jack-Jack. Next, I want to make Jack-Jack sort of pop out against this background a little bit, and that's going to give me the opportunity to show you some of these select tools. First thing I'm going to do is on the background layer, I'm going to click on that. I'm going to go down and choose a new page, and it's empty. I've got a layer here, and I want to fill it with black. So Edit. Where's my fill? Right there. Edit fill. in this case, if I have a black chip already chosen for a foreground color or background color, I could choose it. But I'm going to go ahead and just choose color. Select black. Click OK. Click OK. Now I have a black layer between Jack-Jack and Zombies. And I'm going to go up to the opacity and I'm going to change that to 50. The idea being, if I kind of make that background a little bit darker, then these two focal points here in the front, these pieces in the front, these guys, we can see them a little bit better. Okay, now I'm going to get to some of these select options. So I like this sunshine that's sort of, the glow that's behind the zombies, and I want that to stand out a little bit. So I'm going to come up here. First, I'm going to choose the elliptical marquee tool, and I'm going to just select around that sun. And what is going to happen is I want to remove part of the black pixel so it shows through a little bit better. I need a feather. If I just come up here and I choose my black layer, and then I hit delete, look how crisp that line is. That doesn't look good. That's not what I want. So edit, undo, and edit, undo, clear. And I'm going to put a feather on that. Select, modify, feather. This is set to a radius of 33 pixels. I'm going to raise that a little bit to 44. After you've used Photoshop a while, you just sort of get used to what kind of a feather radius you're going to put on a selection. If I click OK, and then I'm hitting my delete key, see how I now have a nice smooth area here so I don't get that crisp edge where the elliptical marquee is? So that looks kind of nice. We've got Mrs. Incredible, who's looking towards Jack, and we've got this glow that's headed towards Jack. We've got a nice composition going. I want Jack to pop out even a little bit more, so let's use a couple more tools. So I'm going to come up, select his layer, drag it straight down to duplicate it, and in the back layer, I'm going to fill it in with black. First, if I were to choose Edit Fill, it would fill the entire page, this entire thing with black. I don't want to do that. I just want to fill Jack-Jack with black. So if I click on Lock to lock the layer, it's locking the pixels. And I go up to Edit, Fill, again Color, choose Black, and click OK. You can't see it because this black is behind Jack-Jack, but if I change my layers so that the black layer is moved in front, you can see that it's back there. I'm going to undo that or move it back down below. So I'm going to take the black area and move it to the left. And I want to give it a blur. I'll go up to Filter, Blur, and this is something I don't believe we've gone through yet, or that you've seen in any videos yet, and you will in the future. So that's fine. We'll go ahead and we still want to use it in this case though. So Filter, Blur, Gaussian Blur. It's a really popular blur that you'll use a lot. And then depending on how much you want it to blur, and I want it to blur quite a bit, because I don't want it to be obvious. I want it to work with the entire composition without looking like some heavy drop shadow. I'm going to click OK and then come up to where the opacity is, and I'm going to lower the opacity. So I just want him to pop away from the background without it being too obvious. Now I just want to show you a couple of the select options here that we haven't gotten to. That's pretty much all I'm going to do with this image, but let me show you a couple of other things. I can choose one of these layers. I'm going to choose Jack-Jack, and I'm going to go select load selection. Click OK, and it selects him. There's going to be times when you may need to load something in the page. There's different ways to do it. That's one way to do it. Let's say I want the background and I don't want Jack Jack. Select inverse. And of course, there's different ways to deselect everything. And one of them is to go up and choose select, deselect. I'm going to go ahead and select Jack Jack again. Select, reselect, select, inverse. Now I've just got Jack Jack. But let's say I, for some reason, have too much of Jack Jack selected. I could go up to select, modify, contract. I can contract my selection. Let's make it something obvious. By 20, click OK. And now I've got a smaller area of Jack Jack selected. I can also increase it by going select, modify, expand, 40. So that's a way to change your selection size. And select, deselect. I think that's all we're gonna do with Jack Jack for now. I hope that you guys have fun working on this tutorial.